Hey, what's up guys? In this week's video, I wanted to do a follow-up to last week's tutorial where we went over the expression selector in order to create automated bounces. So to expand upon that, I wanted to take two text elements. So one's going to be on the bottom and another one's going to be bouncing on the top. So we'll get the same kind of bouncing, but then squash and stretch as well. So it's going to look something like this. That sounds interesting. Let's get started. All right, so I already have a comp set up. This is using the template from the previous video. If you'd like to check that one out, check the link in the description, and you can also download the code there as well. All right, so I have a text layer, and I want to change this to be weight. I'm going to recenter this with the Ctrl-Alt-Home and then Ctrl-Home. So right now I got the expression selector, but I don't have any attribute associated with that. So as I scrub forwards and backwards, nothing is actually happening because I don't have any property. So in order to add a property, we're just going to click add property. And then for this one, I want it to bounce up and down. So I'll just do a position property. And this is the end position where it currently is. So in order to get the start position, I'm just going to grab the Y value and just pull this up so it clears the canvas. Something around there should be good. All right, so let's take a look at what we've got so far. So just as a reminder, all of these attributes here, all of these variables are controlled on this null object called animation control. On just these values here, you can get different results. Like you can have the animation be a little bit faster, slower. You can change the start frame amplitude, like how tall the bounces are and how quickly the bounces stop with the decay rate. So all of those things can be changed, but this is just default to what we did in the last tutorial. Just playing around with these values will give you different results. Right, so what I want to do now, I want to have another piece of text underneath, and I want it to kind of be squashed down as this weight text comes and bounces up and down. So the way we're going to do that, I'm just going to take weight and then duplicate it. I'm going to rename this to be springs. I'm going to solo this layer. And what I'm going to do, since this is the ending position for weight, if we go all the way to the bottom here, I'm just going to move springs so it's underneath weight. Close weight here. I'm actually going to move this layer underneath. It doesn't matter, but it just kind of makes more visual sense since that layer is underneath the text on the comp. Open up your text, animator, expression selector, and then the amount. And click here, and then we can look at the expression. All right, so the attribute that I've got right now for position is not necessary, so I'm going to delete this one. Instead, I'm going to use a scale. And on scale, as soon as weight comes down right there on frame 3, I want this to squash down pretty far. So right on frame 3, I want this to be crushed, which means that the start frame of this animation needs to be offset. So right now the start frame is still referencing this animation control. So we have a look at here. This is actually starting at frame 0, but on the springs, I only want this to start at frame 3. So what we're going to do, take this. We don't actually need to set up a different slider control for it. You can if you want to, but in my case, I'm just going to put in, it can start on frame 3. So now at frame 3, this will begin. So we'll go down to the scale here and we'll lower the scale quite a lot. And actually what we need to do here, turn off motion blur so you can see what you're doing. So as soon as this crushes here, we want this to go down, lower the scale down to something like negative 100. And when you go forward a few frames here, this is how crushed it's going to be. In order to maintain mass, we need to make sure that both of these values added together equal 200. So right now, if you add these together, you're just going to get 0. So this needs to be 300. It's going to scale it out on the x-axis. And now we're going to get something like this. And then when it comes back, it's going to hit again and again. And we're getting that kind of springy motion. So let's go up to our animation control, and the decay rate at 0.25 basically just slows down how quickly each bounce falls off, but this is taking quite a lot of bounces. So if you want this to be very springy, then I mean, you can even do a decay rate of like 0.1 or something, and then this is going to go on with lots and lots of bounces. So I'm going to increase my decay rate. So if I do a decay rate of 1, let's see what the difference. So there's very few bounces with a decay rate of 1. It's quite good though, I like that. Maybe we'll try 0.75. Or we can do 0.5. Alright, so in order to fix the problem with the motion blur here, a simple solution would be to select weight. Click P for position. Go to a frame where it looks like when weight lands on top of springs, it actually looks like it is hitting directly on the line, like perhaps keyframe 105. So I'll keyframe position at 105, and then I'll go to the very first bounce where weight comes over spring, and I'm just going to lower this position. I want there to be overlap with the motion blur, otherwise it really doesn't look like they're touching. We'll go halfway here and just have a look. So that looks better. Now, if it looks strange to you that the springs aren't really reacting quite as much, but weight continues to bounce, what you can do, you can just tweak the decay of weight, or you could tweak the decay of springs. For example, if you go into springs right here, you don't have to use the decay rate specified on the slider, so this is 0.25, or you can modify this value if you wanted. You could increase it very slightly. You could add a number, or you could multiply a number or something like that. So we could even just do minus 0.05 and just have a look and see what that does. And towards the end here, we're still getting bounces. That might be a little bit too much, so we can try doing 0.025 instead, and that might be a little bit better. So that's continuing even beyond the end, so what we might want to do is just do something very, very small. We might even just do 0.1 or 0.15 instead. So you just have to play around with those values. Okay, so I quite like just 0.02. This also is up to you if you want to include it. The reason why this is occurring is weight has a lot more range that it goes on than springs does. So what you could think of this as is that weight requires a lot more force to push down those springs. And when the weight is, you know, only slightly bouncing up and down, it's barely affecting springs. So it's just up to you what you want to do or what material this is supposed to be made out of. But it's whatever looks the best to you visually. Okay, but this option allows you to tweak the decay. Now, probably the coolest thing about this I found is on the animation control, you go up to your index offset and just play around with the values, like for example, something like 10. You can get each letter in turn to react and bounce as it lands. You play around with these values here, you'll get different results every time. If you don't want the individual letters to bounce, just do some very large value. Like I had it this like divided by 10,000 or whatever up here. So it appears like it's working just as one word instead of all the individual characters, but it's up to you what you decide to do. So this is what 10 looks like. But as long as both of these layers are both attached to the same index offset, you'll get something like this. Let's try a different one here, maybe these even just 20. You can just scrub this value and see what kind of things you like. If you want a very, very subtle kind of wave, you could increase this to maybe like 100 and you'll get more of a subtle type of wave. So this little expression that I've done is kind of like a work in progress. Every time I do set up a new comp, I think of ways I could have more control or improve this. If you guys want to modify this, go ahead. I mean, there's nothing fancy here. It's all pretty simple stuff, but you can use this with other things besides the text animator if you'd like to. For example, if you simply take out the index offset and you remove this from the equations, you can really use this for whatever you'd like. You can use this position, scale, any type of attribute. You can have it controlled with an expression. The only difference is you wouldn't really put this code in an expression selector, you would just put it directly on whatever channel that you're trying to animate. As far as the code works, the only thing that you would have to take off is the index offset, because that doesn't really make sense in this context to use that. But other than that, you can just play around with this, have fun with it. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys learned something. If you did, drop a like. If you have any questions, post a comment. And I'll be back next week with another video. Alright, peace.